Golfer's elbow is a medical condition. Here normally patient complains of a pain and tenderness around the medial aspect of a elbow or the inner aspect of the elbow. Sometimes patient too complains of a spreading of pain towards the forearm region and even to the wrist region. There will be difficulty in holding an object due to there will be weakness in the little finger and the ring finger. So this golfer's elbow is also known as a medial epicondylitis. So here medial epicondyle will be giving a supply to the flexor aspect of the forearm muscle. That will be helpful for the wrist flexion. Golfer's elbow is commonly seen in golf players due to wrong techniques or overuse activities or repetitive activities will put a load on the flexor aspect of the forearm muscles, will lead to inflammation of these muscles, will cause us a medial epicondylitis or golfer's elbow. Besides golf, there are other activities like throwing or lifting a weight or swimming. We do see golfer's elbow due to wrong techniques of hitting a ball or throwing a ball or swimming will lead to golfer's elbow. There are 4 risk factors for the golfer's elbow. If you are above age of 40 years, if you are obese, if you are a smoker, and if you are doing repetitive activities for more than 2 hours, definitely you are more prone to get a golfer's elbow. After listening to the causes and signs and symptoms of a golfer's elbow, I request you to watch full video for the best strengthening and stretching exercises to relieve from the golfer's elbow. Myself, Dr. Girish CM, orthopedic and sports physiotherapist from Promote Health and Wellness YouTube channel. In case of acute stage of golfer's elbow, commonly we see lots of inflammation around the elbow and the forearm muscles, which is due to overactivities of wrist muscles as well as the finger muscles. So we need to prevent as much as stretching and strengthening for the wrist muscles or the elbow muscles. So for that, we need to initially start with the cryotherapy or ice pack to reduce the inflammation. So by placing ice pack for 15 minutes around the elbow and the medial aspect of the forearm will help to reduce swelling and the pain. So this should be repeated for 3 times a day. The next mode of treatment is friction massage of medial aspect of the elbow. So here we need to take 2 fingers, or maybe we can use a thumb. So initially we need to move around the muscle with respect to the skin at the wherever there is a lesion. Normally we can find a taut kind of a structures, maybe due to adhesion formation. So we need to break those adhesion while, you know, moving in a circular way, or maybe up and down movements, or maybe side to side. If you are difficult to do with the thumb, you can use other 2 fingers in a very gentle way like this, circular movements, or maybe side to side, then front and back. So this will help to break the adhesions, so thereby the pain can be reduced. Next, the treatment is wrist flexor stretching. So here we need to take the hand, that is elbow, at a straight level. Then we need to make a fist, then slowly down. So here we need to hold for about 20 to 30 seconds. So I can feel some amount of stretch at the wrist flexor muscles. So like this, we need to hold it for about 30 seconds for about 3 to 5 times a day. Then if you are feeling much comfortable, then we can go ahead further and we can open up and we need to make it much more, taking it down. So here I can feel much more stretch at the wrist flexor region. Then if you want much more, you know, stretching, then we can use other hand and we can, you know, stretch it little more gently so that we get a very good stretch at the wrist flexor region. So this should be holding for about 30 seconds, 3 to 5 numbers we need to continue. Then gradually we need to release. Next is active range of motion for the elbow, wrist and the fingers. Here we need to start very less number as we are aware that there will be inflammation around the elbow and the forearm muscle. So we need to take care of less number of active range of motion only just to improve warm up in the muscles. So first and foremost, let us start with the wrist flexors as well as extensor. So here we need to make a fist, then go down, then complete full range of motion of extension, then take it up. That is flexion. So like this, we need to do it about 5 numbers, 3 times a day. Like this. The next one is, we call it pronation, rotating inside, then outward. So this is, we call it a pronation and supination. So this should be taken care of once again, 5 to 10 numbers. So that we should not aggravate the pain around the elbow or the forearm muscle. If there is any aggravating, so you need to reduce the movement. So next one is elbow flexion, then extension. This will help to keep your muscle in a good status. Once the inflammation around the medial aspect of the elbow and the forearm reduces, I mean to say the pain and the swelling has come down after 5 to 6 days, then we can start to regain building a muscle strength of forearm flexors or wrist flexors. So first initially we need to have the arm bar holding it. Then we need to start with the wrist flexor muscle strengthening. So here we need to take a support of a pillow when you are doing it. Then gradually we need to bend the wrist region. We can hold it for 1 or 2 seconds, not more than that, because there are chances of aggravating pain. So always start, you know, lower numbers, that is 5 numbers initially for 3 times a day. Then after, once this set is been done, then depends on your strength, the pain, you know, depends on the pain, then we can gradually go ahead with the higher numbers. Next one is pronation, then after supination. So here the same way we need to continue, initially always keep it a lower numbers, would help you so that, you know, we are not aggravating the condition. Not only the pain around the muscles we need to strengthen, even the other muscles like a big muscles like, you know, biceps, we need to strengthen for the condition like golfer's elbow. Here we need to hold arm bar, then slowly bend it fully, then slowly take it down. And when you are doing it, very gently we should do it. So same way, we need to continue 5 numbers initially of 3 sets. Once the pain subsides around the elbow, then we can increase the number as you are comfortable. Next exercise is arm stability exercise. Here we need to have this arm bar and we need to hold it at a 90 degree elbow flexion. So now we need to do wiggling movement. So very gently pronation and supination movement. So pronation and supination. But here we see that, you know, full we are not doing it. We are only just, you know, small movement we are doing it to maintain the stability of wrist as well as elbow. Here when we are doing this, lots of muscles around the wrist and the elbow muscles will be working. So this is the movement we need to do it. Initially always starts with, you know, 5 to 10 numbers. Then after ulnar deviations, then radial deviation. Here also very gently we need to do it. But here we are not completing the full movement. Small movement we are doing it and getting back. Small movement and getting it back. And here we are not using shoulder muscles. We are only using the wrist as well as elbow muscles. Next is like this. The same way. Like this. Here once again we are not using the shoulder muscles, only the wrist as well as elbow. Then after, leg is moved. So this will give a very good improvement for the dorsal elbow. Next exercise is teratube eccentric strengthening of wrist flexors. Here I am using the resistance of teratube and bringing wrist up with the help of other hand to a wrist flexion. Then I am leaving the other hand. I am going to slowly controlling the movement in the form of eccentric contraction of the wrist flexors. This is one of the best treatment when you are strengthening a wrist flexors for the dorsal elbow. Now I am repeating it once again. So I am trying to take a support of other hand. I am holding it here. Then I am leaving the other hand. Then I am slowly leaving the hand with a controlled movement. So this will help to strengthen the wrist flexors. So when we are doing this, we need to be very careful because eccentric strengthening will be a little difficult to do it. So initially always start with the small numbers. Then gradually you can increase to higher numbers. Depends on the pain tolerance as well as strengthening of the wrist flexors. Thank you for watching my video. If you like the video, kindly subscribe my channel. You press the bell icon for a future notification. If there is any suggestion or advice, kindly mention in the comment box. Thank you all. Stay safe. God bless you all.